Asian Lifestyle TV.
Grace Park was born in LA, but raised in Vancouver. We first saw her as the dancer girl in Romeo Must Die. You don't remember? Well, it didn't take very long for this North American-born Korean to change that.
Shannon, you rock.
I felt like I was just blathering.
Her first regular role was on CBC's Edgemont High, where she played Shannon Ng.
But Stevie is amazing. She's just so confident about who she is.
And within a few years, she landed the role of Lieutenant Sharon Valerie, making her a household name as a Cylon clone on the hit TV series Battlestar Galactica. Although most of her work is on TV, she recently starred in West 32nd, a film about the gritty Korean underworld in New York, where she had a chance to connect with her heritage.
She wasn't sure what was going on, and she saw somebody come out of Mr. Chun's car.
I didn't know that that stuff happened in New York. I don't think a lot of people do, and that's why it's really intriguing. You go there between, I think it's 5th and 6th, on West 32nd. It's literally one block long. It doesn't go any further, and it goes down and up. Like, you can see all the signs for, like, hotels or Norebang, stuff like that. And it's pretty fun down there, but the movie's about all the other things that happen there.
She said she saw Mike, that it was Mike, and that he got out of the car. And he took off. She was just describing it.
So I don't know that much Korean. My mom helped me out. I put on the iPod. Like, that was pretty much my coaching. I went there, did it on the day, and since the director didn't know very good Korean, Michael Kang, he was like, sounds great to me. until I guess they probably screened it to some other people. And then I had to, like, ADR all my Korean, pretty much. And I thought it was fine. And then when after I started doing it, I realized it was pretty crappy.
And how was it working with the MILF man himself, John Cho?
Okay, thank you.
Alright. John is hilarious. He's as funny as he's on screen, and probably funnier. He was like, we had this, when we were doing West 32nd, I was so excited to finally do a movie. I thought we'd have more time, maybe a little bit more budget, but I knew it was an independent, so I'm like, all right. It was just as fast as television. I was like, I thought we had time. It's an independent, you know, we're gonna go fast. But we had a yellow school bus, which was essentially where all the actors were. I was like, it was the change rooms, and it was wardrobe, and it was hair, and makeup, and the directors were in there. It was like, it was one thing, and so it was like, and it was one bathroom, right? So when John goes to the bathroom, he's like, no, it's just everybody. And he always makes a big deal. He always had me in stitches. It's like, it didn't matter if, you know, when I met him, if I was uncomfortable or not, because he's going to have you laughing.
Her talents have given her a chance to play a wide array of characters, from an unorthodox drug rehab soldier to a border agent.
The border, first of all, is about an elite squad of immigration customs security agents based out of Toronto, and it's them dealing with domestic and international terrorists and international crime in general. What's trying to come into the country, what's happening within our country, so that's what they're doing.
You don't believe in God?
Not really. You?
My father's a Methodist minister.
My character's name is Agent Liz Carver, and she's essentially a Department of Homeland Security field agent. So if you know what that is, that's for the U.S. It's not like, oh, Canada. So because Canada's borders share with the U.S., one of the most important things is, like, how they're going to deal with things coming in and out of the states and stuff. So I'm playing one of the liaisons. I'm gonna follow that sound. So The Cleaner, it's a story about people who are helping others with their addictions. But it's not like it's not like the addict is coming over and saying, we need help. It's a little more roundabout than that, because somebody usually knows the addict.
Don't talk, just help, please.
Look, you asked me to find one or both. I found one, Heather.
Flatliner, get my bag out of the truck, genius.
Either suspects that they have an addiction, they might not know what they're actually addicted to, or they might and they don't know what to do about it. Usually it's a bit, there's a bit of confusion around it often. So enter The Cleaner. And it's a crew of people who essentially were all addicted to something somewhere along the lines, and were all themselves, saved by William Banks, who kind of heads it. They use unconventional methods.